All right, so the third video in this series is a balance stabilization exercise. So when we discussed the situation on the phone, one of the things that you had mentioned was when you're not weight bearing, you didn't experience pain. But as you load through the ankle, start to flex the knee, you start to get that pulling discomfort, that pain, you feel it when you're going downstairs. So we want to experiment with that movement, and one of the best ways to do it is in a single leg balance position. So I'm at the kitchen counter, I've got something stable, safe, easy to hold on to in front of me. And basically what we're gonna do, I'm gonna stand on the involved extremity. I'm gonna start with my knee extended as straight as is comfortable. And I'm simply gonna bend into a knee flex position and then come straight. This is what the motion's gonna look like, but what I want you to think about is I want you to feel your toes, especially your big toe and your pinky toe. I want you to feel your toes grabbing the ground, grabbing the inside of your shoe. And as I go down into this flexed knee position, I want you to think about pressing those toes down. You can imagine as I press my toes down, it actually helps to extend my knee. Throughout the rehab process, most of the therapists, most of the time is spent on thinking about knee extension from the quad, but you can actually improve knee extension from the ankle by pressing those toes, pressing the foot down into the ground. Since the ground isn't gonna move, the knee is gonna be forced into that extended position. So I want to get into the position that produces a little bit of discomfort, but not pain. And then I wanna just get into that position and balance. So I can have my hands on the counter, I can remove my hands, I can touch with one hand, one finger, two fingers. Whatever level you're at the moment, that's where you wanna work. You want it to be a little bit challenging, but you want it to be safe. And you wanna spend 2 to 3 minutes working through that position so that you feel a change in the tissue. You feel perhaps a little bit of burning, you feel like the muscles are working, but it's certainly not increasing your pain. It's certainly not feeling worse later. It should recover in 5 to 10 minutes, perfect. And usually what happens is you have a little less pain for a while because you've changed the chemistry in the area. It's almost like your body produced its own little anti-inflammatory response. Now you can move better, now you can walk better. It'll tighten back up, it'll stiffen back up, but even if it does, you repeat the episode. So we've done 3 things in this video series. We did the eccentric heel drops, we did the self-massage with a rolling pin, and then we did this kind of standing single leg balance, holding onto the counter as needed, knee flexion to knee extension, really focusing on the foot, pushing down into the ground. The foot is the motion that extends the knee. So if you have other questions, we'll address them. For those of you watching this, thank you for watching, and I'll catch you guys on the next video.